What is going on, guys? It's your boy DFastX, and I'm back with another movie review, and this is my review on Shazam, Fury of the Gods. For today's video, if you're here to see more of my excited videos for new to the channel, smash the subscribe button, click the bell icon, and drop the likes. So let's talk right through it. So I went to see this film in the standard screen than the IMAX this time. So I witnessed this. And I gotta say, guys, I really did not enjoy this film. Shazam, Fury of the Gods was not great. Guys, I gotta say that my expectations for this film was absolutely right. From seeing those two trailers that were previously released, my expectations were right. Shazam is mid. Guys, I really wanted to like this film, but my expectations are right. So what the story is about is obviously Billy Batson and the Shazam family. They've now got the superpowers, they're all like him, all that kind of stuff. They're all superheroes, saving the day, all that kind of stuff. They get to confront three new villains, three sisters, played by Helen Mirren, Lucy Liu, and Rachel Zegler. And what the story about it, they tried to, because in the first one, Billy snapped the staff in half. So basically what they do is they reconstruct the staff again and basically take away their powers and stuff in this movie. And they try and plant a new kind of like seed into the ground, a new kind of, I don't know what I'm about to describe, but that's what they kind of basically do in this film. Nothing much really. That's all. That's all I could say, describe a bit of the film, all that to you. That's all there is. Guys, a lot of people are saying that they really like this movie. It's a great movie. It's better than Ant-Man and stuff. Shazam's not good. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? What's so good about it? Because I certainly didn't like it at all. There was nothing, like, there's nothing new in this film that really, like, oh my god, that was so good. Oh, wow. Like, you know, nothing really caught my eye on, like, really, like, no. Like, now, when I break down this film now, that's going to start with the story and the plot. The story and the plot, it struggles. It struggles. It tries its best to try to make a new kind of, like, oh my god, that's really good. That was really good and that and stuff. The story and plot struggles and all that. It's just absolutely, it's not great. Like, absolutely not great. I know people are talking about it and stuff. The story and plot is not great, guys. I don't know what you're talking about on that. It is not a really good. It's not really good. It's really, really poor. So when I watch this stuff, because now these days that when I'm as I do a film course in college and stuff, that I'm looking at like every detail of every movie that I watch are not superhero movies and superhero movies. Of course, like I'm pretty deep with Ant-Man, the Wasp, Quantumania as well. But as with this movie, as I said, the story plot struggles and stuff. The action is great, as always. The action in this movie is absolutely amazing. It's great. And the CGI is great as well. All that kind of stuff. Absolutely. There's no worries about that. Acting is okay. The acting is kind of okay-ish. It doesn't really change stuff. I have a few laugh moments in this movie as well. But I noticed that the jokes in this movie are very corny these days. So they're not actually that funny anymore, like stuff, you know, and like even with his character development, like it really just struggles how to like Shazam, you know, facing new kind of creatures, facing new characters, facing all the kind of stuff. It's just a standard DC standard superhero film. That's basically it. There's nothing new about this film at all. Like, it's not as great. And I'm not saying this as a Snyder fan before you get offended and all that kind of stuff, or say this kind of stuff all in the comments. I'm saying this as a DC fan. A fan of the DC universe and stuff. And I've watched other films as well from the DC universe and all that kind of stuff. I'm just saying that Shazam does not, it does not make a good film. Like what people are saying and stuff. And let me just rephrase this that, like, you know, that I prefer Ant-Man than Shazam. Because I noticed that people are giving too much hate on Ant-Man, which you shouldn't be doing, because Ant-Man was good. It was a good movie. It's not great, but it was good. I actually liked the movie. It was like, I wouldn't say it's the best out of the MCU. It was actually a good movie. Like, I wouldn't say, like, people, I noticed that people are giving too much hate because, oh my god, he's doing this. I don't expect everything that's going to be there and stuff, you know? You know, it's absolutely ridiculous. And I think these days that fans need to, like need to focus their mind of, like, every detail of every superhero film they watch. Like, you know, what was good about the film, what was bad about the film, all that kind of stuff. Like, for me, when I watched Shazam, there were some good moments that I liked. There were a lot of moments that I didn't like. And looking at the story as well, can it get better sort of throughout the film and stuff? And, like, this is no joke, guys. I was there in the cinema last Sunday, and I was just there like this. My head was tilted down like this, at least in 30 minutes into the film. Like, that's how mid it was. Like, Shazam does not develop any new kind of twists in its story and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, a lot of people say, oh, the MCU is in shambles and stuff. DC's the best. They're doing their best, all that kind of stuff. Especially, let me just say this. The DCEU is in shambles. If Shazam is not great like this one I'm saying right now, and so, and people are even calling this already the best superhero movie of 2023. Do not go that far. You all realize that there's more superhero movies yet to come out this year. Guardians 3, The Flash, Blue Beetle, etc. All those kind of ones are coming out yet this year. So do not call it the best superhero movie of the year. That's just the most ridiculous thing, that you're going way too far on yourself and all that. But overall, guys, I just want to say this movie was not great, and it is now ranked at the bottom of my list of 2023. And let me just say this, that Ant-Man is way better than Shazam. And, you know, I just want to say that people should not be giving too much hate on Ant-Man. That you should look at the story one more time and see that, oh, maybe Ant-Man has a better story and we're wrong, but we were wrong about Shazam and stuff. Because people are saying, why people give too much hate and all that and stuff on Shazam? It was actually a great movie. It is not a great movie. That's all I'm saying and stuff. But overall, guys, I'm giving this movie a 4 out of 10. 2 stars. Guys, if you want to go see the cinema right now, it's the cinemas right now and stuff. But if you want to listen to my review of what I'm saying and stuff, do not waste your money to go watch it. Maybe just buy it when it goes on the digital, or buy it on DVD and stuff. That's all. So I just, because it really is poor for Shazam. Like, I don't know. It's just that it struggles to develop new things into this movie and all that, you know. So what are you going to do? It's just DC, you know. So that is my review of Shazam, Fury of the Gods. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I'll be back with 2 reviews in May for Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 and Fast X. So stay tuned for more of my video, guys. Smash the subscribe button, click the bell icon, and drop the likes. And I'll see you all next time. Peace.